looking into the alleged mismanagement of pandemic funds. You know, I had another health secretary here with me a couple of days back, Dr. Manuel Dayret, and he expressed concern, Dr. Cabral, that we may just be seeing the tip of the iceberg here. So to your mind, what other questions do you think must be answered?
Well, we do need to have evidence for these things. And I agree with Dr. Dayret that this may be just the tip of the iceberg, but it is a maybe. It is a feeling that we have. And those feelings need to be transformed into evidence before we can charge anybody. So I hope that something comes up so that we can do this.
You were hoping that the president would lift the ban on cabinet officials attending the inquiry. Obviously,
yes.
Your call hasn't been heeded. What does that tell you, Dr. Cabral?
Maybe it's not important for the president to get all of these facts out in the open. He's already convinced that there is no corruption. He is already convinced that what is happening in the Senate is just grandstanding. He is already convinced that this is all being used against him. So he's not going to do anything about it.
But what to you should be the necessary end of this investigation, of this inquiry?
The necessary end is for us to know who the masterminds are. Because these people are not going to be able to do what they've done just by themselves.
And do you believe, as what Senator Richard Gordon said, that all of these things that we know now could not have happened without the approval of President Duterte, Dr. Cabral?
That is something that cannot be proven. That is just something that we believe. Yes.
What makes you believe that?
Because if that were not so, then the president would not be so adamant about these people coming out into the open with all the evidence that are being asked of them.
Going back to the PSDBM and again the line of questioning of Senator Franklin Drilon, do you believe that this kind of an agency and office should even exist?
For common use materials, yes. But not for this one.
So what kind of, you think, amendment to the law, or what kind of new law, piece of legislation should be made?
Maybe the mandate should be limited they should be limited to what items they can purchase. And I think that initially that was the idea. Just things that all of the other departments and agencies can use. And use.
Kaya lang parang nahanapan ng butas, ano, Dr. Cabral?
Yeah, they always find loopholes like those.
Mm-hmm. And I want to ask you, I want to go back to the statement that you made 5 days ago when you signed that collective indignation statement showing collective indignation. How are you guys doing at this point? The president not heeding your call, the preliminary results being revealed by Senator Richard Gordon, how has this affected the health industry? All the physicians, the nurses, the doctors are frontliners. Dr. Cabral.
We are frustrated that up to now, we are not able to get people on the bench, so to speak, at the hearing to tell us the truth. We are frustrated that they have, including the private individuals who appear at the hearing, they really just stonewall everything. So we are frustrated about that. But yet we are encouraged that there are some things that come out even so that are enough for the senators to say there are crimes that have been committed and that they should be charged. And we hope that very soon these charges will be made.
Otherwise, if charges aren't filed,
let's just all vote wisely next year.
Dr. Cabral, you know, this pandemic is going to outlive this administration. In fact, what we're seeing right now in the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee hearing, it's just a facet of this ongoing pandemic. It's just one of the many faces that this pandemic has. It may look different to you, it may look different to me, it may look different to other people, but the fact remains, this pandemic is going to outlive this administration. So I want to ask you, what kind of leader do you think will shepherd the country out of this pandemic? If we go through all of the contenders, you have Mayor Isko Moreno and Dr. Willie Ong. The mayor has had templates already in the city of Manila. He has proven that he can, and he has been addressing the pandemic. You have the team of Senators Lacson and Soto, who have a wealth of legislative experience between them that could very well map out the blueprint for our exit out of this pandemic. And then you have Senators De La Rosa and Bongo. You have Sakit centers, which of course came from taxpayers' money. You have Senator Pacquiao, who's always had the heart for the people, and then Vice President Leni Robredo, who has been doing her own pandemic response. So among all those, what do you think can best shepherd the country out of this pandemic?
I can't give any categorical answer to that. And you know, with us doctors, the health agenda really transcends partisan politics. It transcends even ideology and religion. So in fact, we are willing to help all of these candidates who might become president come up with a good health agenda. And after that, come up with how we can implement it well. Because you know, a health agenda is easy. It's common to everybody. It is when you implement and execute that kind of agenda that is going to make a difference for the people.
I was told, Secretary, that consultation has already begun. Actually, yesterday you met with a presidential candidate.
Yes, there's a group of us that have come up with this health agenda, and it includes individuals like Kenneth Hartigan Goh and Mingita Padilla, also former Secretary Manuel Dairit, the Dean of the College of Social Welfare in UP, who is also a medical doctor, Dr. Sylvia Estrada Claudio, as well as a very well-known community health physician, Dr. Junice Melgar. And we have come up with an agenda and we have presented it to some of the candidates, including the vice president, including Ms. Senator Lacson, including Senator Bongbong Marcos, and they have agreed to take a look at it and ask us for whatever things they want to know about. And yesterday I went with that together with Secretary Manolet Dairit to the office of the vice president to discuss an aspect of the health agenda, in particular, the COVID response after June 30, 2022.
And that's got to be the core of whoever is going to lead next.
That is correct, yes, because that is the immediate problem that we have.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Always nice talking to you. Dr. Esperanza Cabral there, former Secretary of the Health Department, continue to keep safe. You take care.
Thank you very much, Carmina. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon to you. Thanks.